Hi, Alex here from Rebeloper.com, and in this video I will show you how easy it is to upload your app to the App Store. Well, first of all, we will test how to upload your build to App Store Connect. So without further ado, let's get started. Great. Now, make sure that you do have an app that you want to upload to the App Store. And in this video, as I have mentioned in just seconds ago, I will show you how you can upload a build to App Store Connect. Now, why? What is the difference? Well, the main difference is that uploading a build to App Store Connect is a part of uploading your app to the App Store. It is, well, taking a build that you have created from your project and sending it to the specified place on the App Store Connect that you have also created there. Now, I am working on an app for one of my clients, and I will show you this process with this example. Now, what to know before we upload? Well, first of all, you need to have a bundle identifier, and that needs to be registered in App Store Connect. Well, it needs to be registered in the developer portal of your developer account. So let's check that out, if that is like so. So let's open up our browser here, and let's go to developer.apple.com. Okay, and now let's go to account. Let's sign in and select certificates, identifiers, and profiles. Okay, here we go. And now let's take a look if our AR Sling Master is inside our app IDs. Okay, select app IDs and let's search for AR Sling Master. As you can see, there isn't any. So what I usually do here is go to my Xcode and select capabilities and enable, then disable any of these capabilities. I usually do it with in-app purchases. So let's go there and let's turn that off again, and in just a few minutes this should be updated in our developer portal. So let's search for that again, maybe we have luck. There we go, com.rebeloper.arslingmaster is now registered. Great. Now what you need to do next is go back to your account and this time select App Store Connect. Let's go to App Store Connect. Great. Now, now that we have our app ID in the developer portal, we may create a new app. So go ahead and click on My Apps. And then at the top left corner, go ahead and click on the plus button and select New App. Okay, this will load. Select iOS and I will name this. For now, I will name this AR Sling Master. Okay, let's choose our language, English US, a bundle ID, and now let's select it. Here we go, AR Sling Master, SKU. I usually use SKU as the name without, of course, spaces. Now, user access, I want to have full access. And if you don't know what this new user access is, go ahead and take a look at my video about that. I will link it up here. Okay, let's click on create. And here we are. Now, let's wait for it to load. And we are ready for your upload. Great. That is the work that you need to do before you actually upload. All of our uploads will be available under our activity tab. Of course, now there isn't any. So let's go back to Xcode and select our app. Now, one last thing before we upload, I want to mention is that you must have an app icon. So go ahead and make sure that in your assets folder there is an app icon. I will use this standard Apple one for now because we are uploading, and you haven't guessed it by now, but I will show you in the next video that we are going to create a simple test flight. So I will show you how easy it is to share your test flight apps, your test apps, with anybody. You don't need to have anything set up with users and so on, with emails. It has been simplified by tenfold. So getting back to our business of this video, let's take a look at how we upload it. So again, we need our bundle identifier registered, and we need a version and a build number. Now, let's set this version to 1.0.0. And the build number is 1. That is okay, because we are uploading now to our 1.0.0 version. So if we uploaded this version and we made some changes, we want to bump up that build and upload that next one with, let's say, build number 2 or build number 3. Make sure that you bump up the build number, because App Store Connect will recognize it and will not approve your build. So that's about versions and build numbers. So how to upload? Okay, under your tab here, select a generic iOS device. Okay, and then go to product and clean your build folder, just to make sure that everything is cleaned up. Next up, go to again to product and archive. Okay, now this will take a while according to your size of your project. And it is building and it is creating all of our tasks. Okay, maybe I will fast forward this. Okay, now that the archive has completed, the organizer window should pop up for you. And as you can see here, we have our version and our status. Now, first of all, what you want to do is maybe validate your app. So let's go ahead and validate it. Of course, you don't need to, you can distribute your app straight away, but I really like to do this step to check for anything, any errors that might occur. So I will use this little wizard here, and hopefully we will have everything validated. As of Xcode 10, I had some issues, and this was a very strange issue, so I needed to delete. After a few searches, I have found out that I needed to delete all of my provisioning profiles. They were conflicting with the provisioning profiles from App Store Connect. So let's just click on validate before I tell you what to do. So let's click on validate, and I had to delete all of my provisioning profiles. And you can find all of your provisioning profiles under library, mobile device, and provisioning profile. So go ahead and delete all of them. Anyway, if you are handling your provisioning profiles automatically by Xcode, it doesn't really matter. Once you open up and want to send your archive, then these are created automatically. Okay, now how can you go to your library? Well, if you open up Finder and select Go, then you will, in your case, you will most probably not see this library, but go ahead and click on Alt, and you will be having this toggled on for you. Okay, now let's see how our validation is going, and it is going quite well. And this can take a while. Again, it depends on your project. Okay, now that the validation is created, so we click on and done. Great. Now let's go ahead and distribute our app, and that is what we wanted to do in the first place. So select iOS App Store, because we want to upload it to the App Store. Select upload again, and now it is fetching some data. It is basically preparing a file that we want to upload. So select all of these three or leave them selected, and I want to automatically manage my signing. Click on next, and now it is preparing, it's gathering all of the data necessary for our HIPAA file that will be uploaded to the App Store. Okay, now that we have all of these gathered, let's click on upload. Okay, and now it is uploading. Again, this might take a while for you, and maybe I will just fast forward this again. It will basically go through everything that fetching data from the App Store Connect and basically uploading it to your App Store Connect app. And I will just fast forward this. Okay, now that we have uploaded our app to App Store Connect, let's click on Done. And as you can see, the status has changed to uploaded. Now, let's just double check and go again to your App Store Connect account and select Activity. And as you can see, under version 1.0.0, we have a build number 1, and it is processing. Now, this will take a while. Usually, it takes about 15 minutes for me, and we will get back to this soon when we are going to take a look at how you can create a test flight app and send it to your friends with only one link. So no test flight app installment needed. No, well, they will have to install test flight app. No setup needed. It's only one clickable link that you need to distribute to your friends. Now, that is it for this video. Hope you enjoyed it. If you did, go ahead and give it a thumbs up and subscribe to the channel, and I dare you to hit that notification bell. Now it's your turn. Have you ever had any issues with uploading your build to the App Store? If you did, go ahead and comment down in below, because I really want to hear your thoughts and I want to know how you managed to solve your problem, if you actually did manage to solve that upload problem. Okay, I will see you in the next one.